everyone. This is Anna Raimondi on this Monday night in Connecticut. I'm so happy to be here with you. And before we begin, I just wanted to say a prayer for all those who have been affected by the hurricanes that have hit this area of the world recently, for the people in the Caribbean who have lost homes, for the people in Florida, many of whom are still getting up and running. Many of them do not have electricity. For the people in Texas who are still pulling themselves together, in Louisiana. For the people in the Northeast now who are being hit with tropical storm and a hurricane as well. And for Maria, the Hurricane Maria, who is forecasted to hit in the very near future. So let's just close our eyes and ask God, the power of the universe, to bring peace to Mother Earth. As we ask for forgiveness, for destroying this beautiful planet in many ways. Let's send out our love for the sea, for the wind, for the sun, for the earth beneath our feet, and ask that the winds whistle in our ears, not howl and destroy. That the rain feed our gardens and not flood our land. That the people affected by these horrific natural events will see their way out of it and perhaps even learn something about themselves or other people because of it. And we thank God, the power that is, for his blessings on this country to keep us safe and protected from all natural disasters and disasters that occur by human hand. Okay. So tonight, I wanted to talk about Ascended Masters. The topic of Ascended Masters and a conversation about Ascended Masters would last a very, very long time. So this is only the tip of the iceberg. This is only the beginning. And if you wish to learn more, there is a lot of material out there on the internet and books that you can get your hands on and learn more from. But I just wanted to present it to you as just another way of looking at what's in the universe and perhaps another place to turn when you're in need or when you want to learn or for whatever other reasons. Our path is very diverse. Spiritually, each one of us are pulled to different things, whether it's different religions, different belief systems. We pull different things into our lives. And I ask you all not to judge. Not to judge what somebody else believes. Because as long as it's good and it's coming from a place of love, it can't be bad. So just keep that in mind. The Ascended Masters are not part of any religion. They exist for us all. And there's many interpretations of who they are and what they are. But the one thing that stands true is they are enlightened beings who are full of love and are one with God. So the Ascended Masters were people who have reached enlightenment, so to speak. They are in one consciousness with God, and they no longer reincarnate. They're in heavenly bliss. Some of them bring us peace, some of us wisdom. Some of them bring us wisdom. All of them bring us love, but some of them more than the others. Jesus, as an ascended master, is the master of love. He's the embodiment of love and compassion. Buddha is the ascended master of wisdom. He gave up all his worldly belongings, following the wisdom of his heart that there was something greater. And he brings that to us. Mother Mary is mother of us all. She is the ascended master of humanity. She mothers us. And she brings us peace. There are many other ascended masters, new and old. There are also guardian angels and archangels that work with the ascended master in bringing us these things that can help our journey of life be more successful. They help us connect more fully with the I Am, the God consciousness that runs through us all, which is the love and the vibration of God. We are all vibration. As we connect to the ascended masters, we connect to very high vibrations. The more we connect to the high vibrations, the higher our vibration. As we connect to God, our vibration moves higher and higher. But more than that, as we act in a way that is God-like, our vibrations soar. Also, one of the ascended masters is Saint Germain, who is not really a saint, so he's not a Catholic saint. He was a man that walked the earth, and he brought the whole notion of the white brotherhood, which is kind of a misnomer. It's just the pureness of the brotherhood to us all in the United States. His home is said to be Mount Shasta in California. That's where his energy is. And he brought us something else. He brought us something called the violet flame. And the violet flame is a beautiful violet flame in which the energy of God is. And in working with the violet flame, you can transmute your energy. This is kind of psychological because you go through the process of giving up and receiving. Giving up things of your past, giving up things in the present, changing the way you look at things. And it's all done through this wonderful God energy that is in the violet flame. Now, I understand for some of you, this is a whole new concept. This is a whole new way of looking at things. And what I always tell people is take what makes sense to you. Make it yours. You don't have to follow it the way anybody else does it. Kuan Yin is an ascended master. Zakiel is an archangel of the violet flame. And there's so many more. If you feel that this is something that you can attach to, again, I use that word loosely because you really shouldn't attach to anything, but something that you can relate to, then certainly follow it. You know, when I talk about Mary, again, I talk about Mary, the non-denominational Mary, the Mary not attached to religion, but instead to all of us. As an ascended master, she has reached the place of enlightenment and bliss. And she can help us better from where she is there. She can bring to us messages of love and peace. And of the ascended masters, she is one of the strongest. They are all messengers of God in some way. And they all come through strongly at certain points in history. Because I feel and I hear Mary, and I think that she is appearing and speaking to so many other people. Her messages of peace are very important for us to hear now. And so you can bring in the ascended masters into your prayer line. You can ask for wisdom from the ascended masters. You can ask them to be with you on your journey and to teach you. They're great teachers. They're here to teach us from the other side. They come through in dreams. They come through in random thoughts. They come through in every which way if you're open to receiving. So I ask tonight, those of you who this feels right to, you ask to receive them and so that they can help you on your path. There are so many beings in heaven that want to help us. So many, so wonderful. There are your spirit guides who have walked this earth with you at one point and yet have stayed on the other side because they love you so much and want to teach you in this life. Your guardian angels, your relatives who love you, your relatives who you never knew, but who have a blood connection to you. Ask them all. Recognize that they're here around you to help you on your journey. We are going on a spiritual journey, not just a physical journey. The physical journey is a part of the spiritual journey, as opposed to the spiritual journey being a part of the physical journey. And that's really important to remember, because first we are souls, and we are all trying to find peace within ourselves and the world. We're all looking for that higher love. And we can get it. We can. And it doesn't really take that much work. It takes connecting to heaven in whatever way is perfect and right for you. My way may not be your way. It's okay. There are different roads that lead to the same place. Follow your heart. Follow where you need to go. The ascended masters also help with karma, in learning our lessons, in understanding why we are with some of the souls we are with as we walk the earth, and what they are to teach us and what we are to teach them. Some people come in and out of our lives, but that doesn't mean there weren't lessons learned or karma solved. And then there are big ones. The relationships, the big relationships you have. The ones that bring you joy and the ones that bring you pain. But the ascended masters, your spirit guides, they understand this. And they want to teach us. It's that little voice you sometimes hear in the back of your head. Kind of like Jiminy Cricket. That kind of thing. That kind of helps you through and to understand. That's who's talking to you. That's who's trying to get through. But they all like recognition. So I may be focused one way, and I will be led and taught mostly by the way that I'm drawn. That doesn't mean the other beings are not around me. Or you may be drawn another way. Again, whatever way is best for you. They just want us to be happy. They want us to be in this blissful place. They want us to feel the God within us. Because truly, that's what it's all about. I did a reading the other day with a family who lost another family member. And he was sad, although he's happy. And I said to them, every day we are closer and closer to death. We are born to die. And if you think about that, it's like, why? Like, we're born to die. Because death is the reward. Death is being with God, seeing God. Not that I want to die now, nor should you. Because you got to live through this life first and learn the lessons and feel the love and reach out. Because that brings us into more perfect union with God. So, with that being said, if you have any questions, let's see, please ask. Okay, Eileen, I've had two miscarriages in a row and am frustrated. How should I connect with my ascended master to center myself and keep positive? You can call them in. So we all share the same ascended masters. You can call in Mary, since she was a mother and understands motherhood. You could call in Jesus, the high ascended master of love. You can call in whoever you want. Mary Magdalene is an ascended master. You know, a woman who was misunderstood, not only during her life, but after her life. Very frustrating. She's said to be one of the greatest apostles. And yet, we don't recognize her as that. Call her in to help you in the confusion. Ask for the calmness and the bliss that they can send to you as they help you on the road to peace. You may also want to imagine a violet flame in front of you. And within the violet flame, transmute the energy of pain into love for your future children. Okay, so I'm looking and I'm not seeing questions. So let me just keep looking here. I think I'm going the wrong direction. It'd be great if I somehow got this right someday. How can we give them recognition? Talk to them. Call them in. Read about them. We are intelligent beings. We read. We have intelligence. We have this wonderful gift. Read about them. Read about their lives. Pull yourself in. Read about the life of Buddha. Read about the life of Kuan Yin. These are ascended masters. Read about what they did and how they did it and how they were able to take this life that they had and somehow bring it up in vibration and closer to God. It's not easy to do that. We're not all on the same level that these people were, or these souls were when they walked the earth. One step at a time, baby steps. You got to do it in your way. No one's asking you to become a saint or live your life in that way. But there's a connection that you can make that brings you closer to the energy of God that will be like nothing you've ever felt before. And you will have an immediate understanding. You know, they give us things telepathically as well, and through feeling. Recognize your feelings. Feel. Don't walk away from it. Don't analyze it. Some things just don't need to be analyzed, just felt. It's okay. But calling them in and learning about them would be a wonderful thing. Again, there's so much written about the Ascended Masters. You know, I've taught classes on the Ascended Masters, and even those were the tip of the iceberg. So read about them. Read about who they are. Padre Pio is an Ascended Master. He's a relatively new saint in the Catholic Church, but he was bivocational, and he was a super healer. He's an Ascended Master. You know, they come from every religion. There are Indian Ascended Masters, Jewish Ascended Masters. It doesn't matter where they come from. Christian, it doesn't matter. You know, it's just, they don't have religion. They're here for all of us. St. Francis, Carrie, St. Francis is an Ascended Master. You know, like many of the Ascended Masters, you know, and like Buddha, he came from a family that was very wealthy and gave it up to leave the materialistic world behind and be closer to God. That is not to say that we need to do that. But that is to say that we shouldn't be worshiping the golden calf. We should be worshiping God. It's nice to have things, but not to worship them. But yeah, St. Francis is a very strong Ascended Master. He also gives light to the preciousness of animals in our lives. Animals come through in readings to me all the time because they have unconditional love for us. And St. Francis brings that through. Glasses on, looking for more questions. Let's see. How can we know or connect with our guardian angels? Well, you know, I say this over and over and over again, meditation. The best way to connect with your guardian angel is to sit in meditation, write down a question on a piece of paper with your right hand, dear guardian angel, write a question that is not answered yes or no, but answered in a longer, answer, because they will answer yes or no and leave it at that. Understand, they were never human beings. I've said this before in other live videos I did, and I'll say it again. So these are beings of God, and have always been that way. So if you ask, you know, what your guide, will I die? Your guide will say yes, but not now. If you ask your guardian angel, you'll get yes. Well, that's not really what you're looking for, okay? So write with your right hand, you know, dear guardian angel, and a question, and then sit in meditation and start to feel your angel. They may tell you their names if you ask for that, and just take whatever comes into your mind. Don't say, oh, that can't be. Of course it can be. Anything can be. And then take the pen in your left hand after you're done meditating and just begin to write automatically. Write whatever. Don't think about it. Just let it move across the page. It doesn't have to make sense at that moment, but it will. It always does. And if you can't write with your left hand, then just do it with your right hand. Writing with your left hand, though, takes you out of your processing mind and put you into more of that spiritual place, because it's, and I'm talking about non-dominant hand, because when you're using your non-dominant hand, it's kind of, you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know how to write with that hand, you know, and so just write it down and let spirit move you through that way. Meditation's the best way. And always begin your meditation with a prayer, you know, ask God or thank God for the clarity that the meditation will bring and the connection that you so need. Yes, Anne, and I love Padre de Pio too. Yeah, okay, Marie says, there are so many articles on Ascended Masters. How do we know which articles to read and to trust? You don't know. You feel it. Trust your gut. I have read so many things, and I have to tell you, some things I think, okay, that could be true, but that doesn't resonate with me. So I'm not going to follow on that path. That doesn't mean I don't teach some of these things. You know, I don't have to be totally invested in it. But, you know, when someone like me teaches it, or anybody teaches it, there's a bit of us in it as well. You know, read everything with a grain of salt. Listen to everything with a grain of salt. And do what you feel is best for you. Your soul knows. And you will know too. There's so many ways, you know, to reach heaven, to get through that door. It's so exciting. It's an adventure. We get to choose and pick what works for us, what works for our soul. You know, the ascended masters have gone through many initiations, soul initiations. They've gone through happiness and unhappiness. They have found their bliss with God. If you believe that, then you follow that. If you believe that the angels are around you, in addition, you follow that too. It doesn't have to be one-dimensional. It can be multidimensional. But it has to be what you feel, what you think is right. There's a series of books that are about Saint Germain, and they are very interesting, and they're good, but they're long. Some people can get through them like this. Other people can't. It's like A Course in Miracles. So if some of you may be familiar with A Course in Miracles, it was written by a Columbia professor who was an atheist. And she just got all this information downloaded, and she started to write it, didn't know what to do with it, discussed it with one of her colleagues, and they decided to publish it. And the book really parallels Christianity, the teaching of Christ, and the teachings of Buddha. Compassion. You know, finding yourself. A lot of what I talk about in these videos. Yet I don't follow A Course in Miracles. To me, this is so common sense, all of this. You know, my soul screams, of course, of course, of course. But I find that it's not an of course. That works with my soul. That works with my gut, but not everybody else's. So you find what works for you, and you find what is true to your gut, to your intuition. And they do download stuff to us if you ask for it. You may not know why you're feeling so peaceful, but you are. You know, there are no coincidences, especially once you connect spiritually, you know, and you go into your higher self, which is your soul. Okay. Oh, so Belle says, you have brought me a sense of understanding and peace with my deceased family members. Thank you. Thank you. You guys make me so happy. Okay. What is the best way to connect with friends and family that have passed away recently? People that have passed recently, it's very difficult to connect with them until they're gone a while. They connect with us during the first month and a half. The best way to connect with them is to pay attention to your dreams, be awakened to what you see around you, to talk to them. It takes a while for them to be able to really connect with you. Okay, Heather Faye Dawson writes, I'm currently reading I Remember Union, the story of Mary Magdalene. It's very beautiful. There's another great book, and it's called Mary Called Magdalene, and it's written by Margaret George. It's a beautiful book. And not just for Christians, it describes the times in Israel, what was going on, the heartache, the pain of being a Jew in an oppressed nation, and it also describes Mary's love for Jesus and his teachings. It's a novel. So, you know, not everything in it may work with you, but again, who cares? Take out what does. There's also a series of books that are very interesting, again, novels, and they're, the first one is called The Expected One, and it's also a story that connects to Mary Magdalene. Again, it's a novel. But I do believe when people write novels like this, there is something from heaven that is moving through them. It's the inspiration. It's coming from their souls. So there's always truth in them. So just read them and you decide what works for you. Again, we have free will. We choose. Okay? So our soul may bring it up. Our soul may say this is true. But it's up to us to really say, I stand on this. This is truth. I understand this. I understand this to be my truth. And you can be as eclectic as you like. You can practice whatever religion you practice and bring other things into it. Or you can just be spiritual. It doesn't matter. But you got to bring in what makes your soul flourish. And that's really important. Because that's the way to true happiness. In this lifetime and in the afterlife as well. Do you feel when we go to heaven, it feels like home? Like we were there before we were born? Heaven is it. We long for heaven every day of our lives. Okay? We've chosen to be here as souls so that we may do the things that perhaps we didn't do correctly in our past lives. Heaven is what's all it's at. I've known people, you know, who go to temples or churches and feel God and long for that feeling. Long for the feeling of being home. It's the source. It's what it's all about. So when we go there, we do recognize it. Our soul knows. Thank you, Barbara, for that. She says, it's heartwarming to hear the genuine and inclusive way you explain how we are all meant to find our own way, listen to our soul, learn to trust our own heart. Anne writes, Anna, have you considered having a list of good books that you recommend on your site? I really enjoyed all the books you have recommended. Unfortunately, my site got too big. And so when I did my site in the beginning and everything was there. I had books on there, I had everything. And when my site was redone, I was told there's too much on it. So there's no room for the recommended readings anymore because there's too much going on there right now. If you want a book, if you want me to recommend a book, ask for it. You can ask for it on this Facebook page so that everybody else can see it. I can recommend a host of books to all of you. You know, just tell me, you know, what you want to read and I'll, you know, what the topic is, and I will certainly recommend them. Sometimes I can do it from the top of my head, sometimes I can't. But there's a lot written out there that we all can learn from. Again, you know, writers write with inspiration, you know, no matter what they're writing. And there's a piece of them in it, but there's also a piece, especially with the spiritual writers, there's a piece of something else. There's a piece that will touch your heart. There's a piece that they're getting from heaven. You know, so you can't deny the book, The Shack. You know, The Shack, if some of you have not read it, I think they made a movie out of it. I can almost swear they did. But the book, you know, was kind of a controversial book because this man wrote this book. And in the book, God is a black woman. And I don't remember who the other people were. It was the Holy Spirit and Jesus. But when he sent out the book to be published, he sent it to the Christian publishers. And they said, absolutely not. This is not a Christian book. Go to the New Age publishers. And he sent it to the New Age publishers. And they said, no, this book is too Christian. So he decided to self-publish the book from his garage. This book has been published in every language. And again, it doesn't matter what religion you believe in, because it really isn't a Christian book, except that Jesus is in it. And think of Jesus however way you want. You can think of Jesus as the Messiah, the great prophet, the great healer, whatever way you want. He is the embodiment of love. And that's how that book was written. He was inspired to write this book. You know, and it was inspired by the death of a child. And that's how this book came to life. So, his truth comes through it, but along with his truth comes a definite feel of the hand of the divine. What are your thoughts on receiving Reiki? Is this a safe practice? What should one look out for when seeking Reiki treatment? Yeah, I'm a Reiki master. Reiki is divine energy that moves through the practitioner. It has nothing to do with the practitioner. If a practitioner tells you that she or he can heal you, run for the hills, because we are not doing the healing. It moves through us. I don't practice Reiki anymore. I don't see clients anymore. But when I did see clients, I felt the energy moving through me and releasing and moving. Reiki energy has innate divine intelligence. It goes where it needs to go in the person. It is driven. It is the energy of God. So when you're looking for a Reiki practitioner, the religion of the person doesn't matter. None of that matters. You don't have to interrogate them on what they believe or what they don't believe. But I would ask them where the energy comes from. And if they tell you it's coming from their hands, then again, they're not someone you need to be with. If they say it's coming from the highest source, then that's a good person to be with. You know, it's like a doctor. You know, healers, you know, help you heal. They don't cure you, okay? You know, they're healers, okay? Nobody's saying a healer is a cure. And when you go to a doctor sometimes, you know, your doctor's not going to promise you a cure necessarily, but will maybe help you get to that cure, will help you heal you enough so that you're cured. It's the same thing with alternative medicine. And it always has to work with you. I mean, I've been to doctors that I love and I feel comfortable with, and I've been with other doctors that I never went back. It's the same thing. You have to feel it. You have to feel a connection. You have to follow your gut, your intuition, what your soul is telling you. Don't deny that. It's a big part of who we are. It is who we are. And the more we follow it, the more we're going to get to where we need to go. So yes, it's not that I believe in Reiki. I believe in the energy of God to heal. And that's what moves through the practitioner. Okay. Carla asks, is the human race preparing for an event? God is preparing us for an event. We need to change. That's the event. We need to go closer to God. How much more can we hurt the earth? How much more can we hurt ourselves? How much more can we hurt each other? And this starts at home. It starts with families, as Mother Teresa says, and then it moves out into communities and towns and cities and countries and globally. The event is the recognition that we are one people made by one creator. We are all one. When will this happen? When will we get there? You know, Mary has told me over and over again, it's about prayer. It's about coming together. It's about compassion. It's about raising our vibrations. It's about being good in every sense of the word. It doesn't mean you don't get angry. It doesn't mean you don't have fear, but your anger and your fear should be minimal compared to the love that you have for the divine and your faith. That's important. Okay, so Barbara is saying that she really liked Margaret George's book on Mary Magdalene. and she recommends it. As I just said, it's a great book. Yes, The Shack was a movie, and you can see that, I guess, on Netflix or something like that. Okay, let's see if there's any other questions. Okay, just remember, this is your life. This is your path. It's up to you to go straight, to make a left, or to make a right. But in the end, when it's all said and done, we have to watch this movie of our life, and we see how we affected everybody else. And there's help from above. We're not all alone. Whether you're going to the Ascended Masters, your guardian angel, your spirit guides, your relatives who are passed, go. Ask them to pray with you, because the one who brings the miracles is God, the highest power, the divine, whatever you want to call this high energy, this highest vibration. Miracles happen every day. You can see them in your own lives. You can see them in the lives of your friends or acquaintances. You can see them through your heart. You can understand them with your mind. But it doesn't matter. What matters is they're there. And we're not alone. And that's really important. It's a nice place to be. When you're in a room all by yourself and you know you're surrounded, keep talking, keep claiming, keep walking the path of your soul. That's a blessing that's been given to each one of us. I am blessed. You are blessed. I pray that you will walk with the angels, the ascended masters, and more important, you will walk with God. Thank you. Good night.